Today, we'll be going over the different types of drivetrains. When choosing what drivetrain you want to have, there's a few things you want to consider, such as speed, power, maneuverability, traction, terrain, and omnidirectional. These are all things we'll be talking about once we get into the drivetrains. There are a few different drivetrain types: four-wheel drive, six-wheel drive, a mechanism, X-drive, H-drive, dreads, and swerve drive. So first, we'll get into the four-wheel drive. So four-wheel drive has good traction, but has poor maneuverability. It has a 2-traction, 2 omni wheel with off-center rotation, good traction, and good maneuverability. 4 omni wheels, which has good traction, but has poor maneuverability. You can also use 2-traction, 2 omni wheels, which gives you off-center rotation, good traction, and good maneuverability. You can also use 4 omni wheels, which give you good maneuverability, but they have poor traction. Next, we'll get into the 6-wheel drive. So 6-wheel drive has high traction because of the 6 wheels that it has, and has good maneuverability, and it's very versatile, but it cannot strafe. So you guys just heard strafing, right? What is strafing? Well, a mechanism drive is mainly known for its strafing. It has high maneuverability, good traction, and it can strafe, which means it can move left and right without turning. And it's best on flat field, and also requires exact measurements for best application. The X drive. The X-Drive has high maneuverability, but has poor traction. It can also strafe like the mechanism drive. It has an unorthodox motor placement, and it can have a static buildup. The H-Drive has high maneuverability. It can also strafe, but it has poor traction, and the space and motors are very consuming. So if you look at the picture here, there's not much space to build off attachments, as most of the space is taken by motors and wheels. Treads. So treads have really good traction, as you can see, and they're very good for terrain, but they have very poor maneuverability, and they require very high maintenance as they're prone to braking. Lastly, we have the swerve drive. Swerve drive are known for its maneuverability and have really good traction, but there's a downside to this, as there's a very complex program, it takes a lot of space, and the design is very complex. We would not recommend this to rookie teams. Thank you.